Priya Sapaha. Today I am going to discuss abetment in the Indian Penal Code. This will be part 1. Because abetment is very lengthy, it has been described right from section 107 to section 120 of IPC. So in this video, I will explain only the meaning of abetment, definition of abetment, 3 levels of abetment and punishment in a very precise form. So let's start. Now, what is abetment? If you look at the literal meaning or a dictionary meaning, it is simply helping or aiding or facilitate someone or to assist someone. As far as IPC or Indian Penal Code is related, any crime may be committed by any individual or more than one person. That means that it may be one person which is involved in a crime or more than one person. Now, if we have to establish the liability of a particular act, then it depends upon the extent of participation of that person on the crime which has been committed. Secondly, as far as in Indian Penal Code, abetment has been described. Abetment clearly differentiates between the person who is behind the scene, that means the person who is instigating or aiding any person to commit a crime, and the person who is actually committing a crime. That means there is a joint liability of 2 persons. The person who is making another person to commit a crime in any manner, that I will discuss later, and the person who is actually committing a crime. So there is a distinction between the two, and it is a very lengthy description. That means abetment has been described right from section 107 to section 120 of the IPC. One more thing, to establish abetment, it is necessary to establish mens rea. Mens rea means guilty mind. The detailed notes about the mens rea and actus reus I have already explained in my previous video. I think the first video, that is element of crime, you may look at them. But as far as abetment is concerned, it is necessary to establish that there is a guilty mind to make another person commit a crime. Similarly, the provision related to the offense of abetment required the presence of knowledge about the act and its effect thereof before the conviction can be made. So it is important that the person is having not only the guilty mind, but he is also having a knowledge that what will be the consequence of the act for which he is making another person or instigating any other person to commit a crime. The definition of abetment has been described under section 107 of IPC, which says that if a person is abetting any other person for the commission or omission of any act, then it comes under the category of abetment. That abetment can be of 3 types. That means the first one is instigation, that means abetment by instigation. Second is abetment by conspiracy, and third is abetment by intentional aiding. So these are the 3 categories for which if a person is abetting another one for any sort of unlawful act, for commission, in the way of commission or omission of a crime, it comes under the category of abetment. Now, how the commission or omission comes under the category of any offense? Commission is simple to understand. If any person is abetting another person to commit a crime, that causes commission. Now, as far as omission is concerned, if any person is having a legal duty towards any other person and another person is abetting that person to not perform that duty or instigating him to omit that duty, that comes under omission of duty. So, abetting any person in a form of instigation or in a form of a conspiracy or in a form of intentional aiding, that comes under abetment, which has been described under section 107 of IPC. Let's discuss these 3 levels in details. First one is abetment by instigation. That instigation could be in any form. It may be by inciting someone or by urge, encouragement, provoke, counsel, procure, command for any sort of commission or omission of the act. Now, for example, if a person, there may be two person who are jealous of any other person. Maybe that person is doing good in the job. So there are two person who are jealous of him. One person does not show his jealousy in front of every person, but the another one, who is usually of short temper, he always shows his jealousy towards that person. So the person who is smarter, that he is the person who doesn't show anything, he is continuously encouraging or provoking that person to do something wrong or something illegal to that person who is getting a promotion. And after listening, after the provocation of that person, if the person commits any illegal act, it may be a hurt or a grievous hurt or anything else that comes under crime, then a person is responsible for doing an abetment by instigation. The person who is just instigating or provoking the another person, he is called the perpetrator. But the person who is actually committing a crime will be called as an accused. He will be an accused. But the crime is committed by both, because both are having a joint liability. How it is possible, that I'll discuss in my later videos. Now, these things, the level of provocation or encouragement or incitement, anything, that can be directly or indirectly. That person can directly also do that thing or indirectly also do that thing. It may be written or it may be oral. It may be by a genuine way or by saying something, or it may be by gesture or by any hint, that to encourage someone to commit a crime. Similarly, it is sufficient that there is an active encouragement of commission of that crime. And it is also important to note that only instigating any person, and if that person is not committing any crime even after instigated by the another person or by the abettor, then it does not constitute in the category of abetment of crime. Because it usually happens, a person can abet anyone for anything or for any act. It could be commission or omission for the illegal purpose. But the necessary thing, there must be a proximate casual connection between the instigation and the act committed as a result. If only abetment is there and there is no result, there is no act of that abetment, then it doesn't come under the category of abetment, rather that doesn't come any activity or any category of commission of crime. And as far as explanation is concerned, there must be willful misrepresentation of a particular thing so that a person can be instigated. Similarly, there must be willful concealment of a material fact for which a person is bound to disclose. If you are willfully concealing the fact to the another person, from the another person, for which that person is bound to disclose, then also it comes under the category of omission of any act. So that is called abetment by instigation. Next is abetment by conspiracy. As far as the meaning of conspiracy is concerned, it is basically meaning that there must be an agreement between the two persons to conspire or to make a plan to commit anything illegal or unlawful in nature. For that, it is necessary that there must be a conversation between the two persons, there must be an exchange of thought between the two persons, and after that, there must be an agreement between the two persons to commit any illegal act and with a proper planning, how to commit that particular act. That is called abetment by conspiracy. Now, here I would like to mention that a conspiracy, which has been described under section 120 of IPC, is different from abetment by conspiracy. That I will make a separate video for the difference between the abetment by conspiracy and conspiracy. Here, abetment of conspiracy, only having an intention to commit a crime is not sufficient. It is necessary to do an act also. If there is only a planning that we are going to do something illegal or unlawful act in future, and if they are not doing anything, it is not at all an abetment by conspiracy. But as far as conspiracy is concerned, if a person is planning to do certain things, that comes under conspiracy. How and why, that I will discuss later. So we will only discuss abetment by conspiracy. In a simple manner, if the person are planning to commit a crime for which one person is abetting another person in a form of a conversation by exchanging a thought with another person, in which that person is only conspired, he is behind the scene, he is not actively participating, but he is a mastermind of that particular conspiracy for any sort of unlawful act, then it comes under abetment by conspiracy. Next is abetment by aiding. Now what is aiding? If by intention anyone is helping another person in any form, then it comes under abetment by aiding. For example, A wants to kill C and B is helping A by providing him either a poison or any sort of weapon which is helpful to kill C, then it comes under abetment by aiding, because here he is only providing that thing to kill C. He is not actually committing any sort of murder. So this is called abetment by aiding. The second example is a form of helping. Like if any person is planning to commit a theft in anyone's house, and a servant of that particular house just open the door and help him to commit that crime, that also comes under aiding. Now in these type of aiding, for which there must be intention, that means mens rea is necessary, and not only the guilty mind, it is also necessary that there must be a knowledge of the consequence of that particular act. If a person is helping another person to commit a crime in which that person who is helping is not at all aware that the thing for which he is helping is going to be a commission of a crime, he may be helping that person for a goodwill, then it doesn't come under the category of abetment by aiding. That's why it is necessary that there must be intention and knowledge of the consequence of the act of abetting by aiding, even by abetting by instigation or even by conspiracy. So there must be these things which is necessary to commit any sort of crime. This is very necessary. Next is punishment for abetment. Now as far as punishment is concerned of abetment, this is the only type of a crime for which a specific punishment is not mentioned anywhere in IPC. Only in section 306, abetment for suicide, the punishment is explained or described. Otherwise, it depends upon a type of or a form of a crime. If there is an abetment for theft, then the punishment will be related to theft. If there is an abetment for murder, then the punishment will be related to murder, and so on. So it depends upon a type of an offense, and whatever is the offense and which sort of abetment has been done, then the punishment will be decided. The detailed notes related to the punishment, I will make a separate video for this. So this is all about abetment in the Indian Penal Code Part 1. In this video, I have described the meaning of abetment, definition of abetment under section 107 of IPC, and the three levels of abetment. Similarly, the punishment is also described in a very concise form. For the detailed notes, you may visit to my website, that is priyasipaha.com, and you may also follow me on FB page, that is Law Colleague Q, on Instagram, Law Colleague Q, Twitter, Dr. Priya Sipaha, and on YouTube, Dr. Priya Sipaha. Thank you for watching. Hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. See you soon. Bye bye.